Welcome to a lesson on subtracting integers with two color counters. In this lesson, we'll look at examples of subtracting integers where we don't have to add extra zeros. In the next lesson, we'll look at examples where we have to add extra zeros to find the difference. The set of integers is defined here, and for our lesson, one yellow counter is equal to positive 1, and one red counter is equal to negative 1. So we can represent positive 2 using two yellow counters, negative 3 using three red counters, and we can represent 0 using one yellow and one red counter. And there is more than one way to represent an integer using two color counters. And this will be important for the second lesson. We take a look at these counters here. Notice that three red counters and three yellow counters would simplify or be equal to 0, leaving us with two yellow counters, which represents positive 2. So together, all these counters would be another way to represent positive 2. Looking at the counters below, again, notice how these five red counters and five yellow counters would simplify to 0, leaving us with three red counters, which would represent negative 3. So together, all these counters would be another way to represent negative 3. Let's look at our first example. Here we have 7 minus 4, or if we want, positive 7 minus positive 4. Let's first represent positive 7 using 7 yellow counters. Now because we have minus 4, we want to remove or take away 4 yellow counters. So if we remove or take away these 4 yellow counters, notice how that would leave us with 3 yellow counters, which is equal to positive 3. 7 minus 4 equals positive 3. Now let's take a look at negative 8 minus negative 3. We'll first represent negative 8 using 8 red counters. Remember, if we wanted to, we could add extra zeros here and still have negative 8. And now because we have minus negative 3, we want to remove or take away 3 red counters. So if we remove or take away, let's say, these three red counters, notice how this would leave us with 5 red counters, which is equal to negative 5. Negative 8 minus negative 3 equals negative 5. We're going to stop here for this lesson. Again, in our next lesson, we'll look at examples where we'll have to add extra zeros in order to perform the subtraction or remove or take away the correct counters. I hope you found this first lesson helpful.